Hello everyone. Today we want to talk about maintenance in real estate module. Before starting maintenance of real estate, we need to have a look to some information are required to fill these forms. This information will go to the top. This is property list. So we need to fill this one. Information, create, new, fill the information for the property. Then we need to also fill the unit list because we want to know for which unit we did the maintenance. Okay, from here you can create a new item, a new unit. Unit means maybe flat, maybe shop, maybe office and so on. Then after creating these two, we need tenant list also, so we can know information about the tenant. If some companies don't like or they don't have information about the tenant because they make invoice directly to the customer, to their customer, which is the owner of the building, in this case no need to fill the tenant. They can put the owner name, one-time name. Also, maybe we need to have the inventory list. In the inventory list here on the left, in the inventory list, they might need, here is to open a new item for the inventory list. They might need to put inventory on the that they change a spare part, maybe, or maybe they want to put kind of service, what service they did, okay, and so on. So this one about the items that we needed for the maintenance. Now we'll go back to maintenance. Maintenance can start from this, or can start directly from the job card. If you start directly from the job card, you need to select create job card. So this is from the scratch you will create. But you have an option to create job card from complaint or maintenance, which is available here, this one, complaint and maintenance. So we'll go one by one. Request for maintenance, we receive by phone. Request for maintenance for the building number 4, and this is the unit. Now the unit display here, disregard if this unit occupied or not, you can fill this one. You can see all information. When you select the unit, you will see the tenant name, maybe sample tenant number 2, and you will see all information here. Maintenance, you will select from drop down what you want to do, AC cleaning, for example. Now this AC cleaning, this one coming from the general list. General list, if you press F2, okay, you can add any number of maintenance reason. Okay, F2. Now F2 is general list. Let me go and show you this one. This is on the left side list, as you see. Then general list. General list, you can use this one for the whole system, or you can use it part of the module, part of the module. This is the general list where you can see main sub, as you see, you can select and you can find here maybe maintenance. Okay, anyone, you can search for it. Use the name maintenance, for example, you can see this one. And there is accounting, fixed asset, and so on. Okay. So my point is you can add any type of maintenance you want to do. Then the date requested, and if finished date, it will be filled here. And here is the, you put information according to request of maintenance you received. You might receive it by phone, you might receive it by email, but this one has to be filled manually, okay? In every window there is help like this, press F2 for a quick add. Okay, close this one. No. Yes. After creating the request for maintenance, then you can make, create complaint. Complaint or maintenance. Okay, this one from this window. Now you can see reference number automatically. You can go to previous to see previous. One here is sample, building number two, reference number two, date 14/9/2019. Complaint from tenant, or maybe from watchman, or building inspector from where. The status of this one is created. What is the unit number? You can select. Okay, phone number, and you can send SMS. Then you have here two types. One is complaint, one is maintenance. And you can use this one, complaint or maintenance. Now vendor name, from where you want to buy items for this vendor, and also this, if you want to select this one, select the vendor name. If to create interbill for maintenance company, and maybe you want to buy, if you can fill this one, if you want to buy purchase from this vendor, but this is not a must. Okay, now unit detail, you can find it here, this one, city, country, all information. This one, reading based on the building and unit number and tenant information. Okay, if you created this one, I think. Okay, see now information has been filled, family, etc., Electra, and so on and so on. Okay, so this is coming automatically. What is the control run? And if you didn't fill with this one, it's not a must. Flat status. But even you are maintenance company, you are not doing renting, it's better to have information about the tenant and the unit. Now this is the complaint. Again, you will type whatever you want. Okay. And complaint, you can select from this one, change brake, change oil, AC, change fan, etc. So all of this you can automatically display. And as we mentioned, press F2, you can add more items when you press F2. Okay, then here the complaint subcategory, you can select, if you selected here, maybe AC, maybe there is subcategory, it's not filled, and here the note. So all of this you can fill as much as you want about the complaint or maintenance details. So this is this step. After you finished, okay, you can edit and you can print. Now about printing, there is an option to design. Look to the left side, design here, set up templates in real estate, sorry, in maintenance, real estate maintenance. You can design the complaints, the job card, and job card invoice. Complaint like this one, you can create a new one, give the name, complain. Okay, say okay, double click, and you can design it the way you want. This one, double click logo, you can move the logo, company name, country, everything, information. Now building information, okay, you can take this information, like name in this way, you can design, and we will help you to design, because this one, normally sample is available, but if the sample is not available, we will help you to design. But in general, the sample is always available. And here you can select the flat if you want somewhere, see all information, you can select flat number and so on. Okay, in this way. Now, yeah, as I mentioned, if this one not available, we can work this one for you. But in general, for the templates in accounting all these templates are available. Okay, a lot of templates, too many are available. So let's come back to real estate maintenance. You create complaint or maintenance, you can print. After this one, you want to take an action. You want to take an action. So the first one is you read, you take general information from the tenant. This one you fill in the form, because this one it is affecting to next step, which is what is the action? What I should do with this order? Change the date to see what we have. Now here you have this order number 2 created. Okay, sample building. You can see more information if you like. And you can see the status for each one. You can change the date. You can filter from this window. Okay, and you can click here to change the action. What you want to do. What you want to do. These are the action we can say, because this one is created. This one is created. You can put the date, assigned to job, or done without creating job card. Maybe I don't believe that I have to do maintenance. Done without a job card, and I can put the reason here, type the reason. Or maybe this request for maintenance or complaint may be rejected. Okay, I put the note, who rejected, why rejected, and so on. Maybe on hold, or maybe other reason, other things here. Okay, and I can put general notes in this window. Again, the sample is there, building information is already here, and so on. Okay, so this one is action on the job card. Action on the complaint. Still, we didn't open job card. Okay, now after that one, we will create job card. Now, job card created from the complaint or maintenance from this window. So, I created, I can open job card. I can change maybe 2000. Okay, I should find the job card in this list. Here is list on the complaints or maintenance that already has the assign to job. Now I didn't assign, means I should come to this window. I should come to maintenance, this window. Okay, here, sorry, action. I will select, let's say, 20. This one, okay, action. I must take assign to the job card. Then click here, okay. Please select an existing name. I need to select here, noted by, select the name, if there any name. Then this one. Now I assign, close this one. Go to real estate, then maintenance, job card, create job card. Maybe any date, search. Okay, I found this one here. The one I assigned, I found it here. Now I can create job card from this one. Look here, list only complaint that already has assigned to job card. I can create job card from this window. Now here is the important job card. First of all, I have the all information about the unit. Okay, then complaints, it's autofill here. It is autofill here, the complaints. Then service, what I want to do. This one I cannot fill because already coming, reading from previous step. This one service, okay, I have to select what service I want to do. Now this one from where reading? Reading from, go to the left side, okay, go to item and select here the service. These are the service. This tab is the service. So this one is coming in this window. Okay, the service is coming in this window. Then you put the rate, quantity, amount, labor. Is this charged to tenant? You can fill. Or charged to maintenance department? You can fill. Where it is, it charged. Allah, for you tenant, maybe for you as a maintenance company, you can create this one to charge to your customer, because in the tenant list, you can put your customer. In tenant list, you can put your customer, which is who's the owner of the building. Okay? You can save and print. You can print the job card. You can save, close, etc., clear, and so on. Okay? After doing creating job card, you can edit, you can print. As I mentioned in the beginning, you can create job card directly. No need to go to these steps, or you can read from the previous step. Okay, edit and print job card. Now action on job card. Action on job card. Again, this one, search. I have, this is finished. Other action finished. I will take the action from this one. Maybe finished, waiting for items. Maybe still not finished. Maybe waiting for labors and so on. So I keep updating. And here the name, who employee who added this note. Okay. Then I wanted to continue this one, action on the job card. I wanted to see this one, that this list only the job cards that are created, printed, and will not affect inventory and goodwill. Still here, no effect to inventory. When it will affect inventory, now last step after you take job card action and you say it is complete, you can go to make cash invoice or credit invoice. Cash invoice or credit invoice. Now this one, credit bill, from job card. This one, as I mentioned in the beginning, that maybe this items I want to order, or I bought it from this vendor. So when I click this one, okay, I will read the items and I will create the bill for the vendor. What is bill? Means accounting wise, it's like purchasing. This is the bill. Purchasing. So this form will fill automatically. Okay, this will fill automatically. But this form, it will come France, create invoice, job card, cash invoice, or credit invoice. Okay, we will select if there is any items. Select. Okay, this item sample, finished, and so on. I can choose to take cash invoice or credit invoice, see automatically cash invoice, and I can put VAT, my margin, VAT might take automatically if you set up this item. If there is inventory, it will be filled here from the job card. From the job card, we can fill the inventory. Actually, unfortunately, I didn't concentrate on inventory. I'll go back to action on job card. Let me take if there is any job card here. Okay, this job card action. No, not from this one. No, at the time when I open job card from the beginning, this is the job card, the new job card. Here I want to show you that there is your inventory. It's reading inventory. From where reading inventory, look to the left side, item list. Item list reading this one. So an item list, it is affecting to inventory and service. Complaints is reading from general list. This one by default is reading. Okay. Then I will go to maintenance, cash invoice, credit invoice, and bill, finished. Now this one, notice I can print this one. I can print for all tenants, all together, unit. I can assign the unit, all information, subject, and so on. And this notice, this form will not affect accounting and the status of the unit. No affecting accounting, just a letter. Okay. Now this one, here, you go to templates, left side, maintenance, real estate, there is complaints, there is job card, and there is job card invoice. Okay, in real estate, here there is notice. Okay, this notice, the one I showed you before, you can design and bring the notice. You can design and bring the notice. Here is a new notice. Okay, then the same way, open, double click. Then you can select anything you want and you can design. Also, normally there is sample, but since there is no sample, we can customize for you. No sample as of today, 28 June 2020. But we will add, of course, this one later on. All of these, we can add this one. But it's very easy to make this form. It's not a story. Close this one. So in real estate, again, notice, you can create and print. Print notice, this one. Okay, you can print to group. You can print to a group notice from this window. Just in notice category, we need to fill that category, information, notice 1, 2, 3, etc., etc. Fill all information and print the notice. You can export to Excel, as you see down. You can print the list, as you see, print notice, and their system will display all the active units for create and print notice. The active units, any inactive units, it will not be printed. Okay, on their right side, there's customized columns. Anything you don't want, you can remove. Suppose some information, you can remove like this. Okay, simple information, more information in this way, okay? Then we will go to general memo. This is general memo for the company, for the all tenants. That's why here you can put it for him directly, or you can select the memo category. If there is memo, press F2. Press F2, you can add. This is in the general list. Okay, with every window, there is all information here. Okay, now here is the system. Okay, integrated with accounting, as I mentioned. As maintenance company, only you do maintenance, so you don't need all of these options. You don't need VAT, etc., etc. But if you manage other buildings, if you manage other buildings, you can use this one to calculate your commission. Okay, here you can change unit status. Unit status, okay, you select the unit, then you can print this one, or you can change the status from this window, void or cancel contract based on the setup. I just want to show you just quick look to setup for real estate. I know you are maintenance company, but I'll show you setup for the real estate. There are some conditions about real estate. Okay, if you want to run real estate completely, and there are some more controls about real estate. Okay, now we will go to reports, then real estate report. Here is real estate maintenance, complaint list, job card list, and comprehensive complaint list, and this one. Comprehensive will open this one. There is one more here, complaints list, job card, notice, general memo, but let's go to comprehensive one. Okay, maybe we write 2000 and this one. So this is the report, assuming that all information, you can see more here on the right side. Here is the reference number, date, status, building, unit, asset code, asset name, complaint, service item, what we use, quantity, rate, amount, labors, who work on this one, labors, okay, and the memo. You can filter, because this form is for maintenance of real estate and maintenance of fixed asset, okay? Both of them, here you can filter by unit, which unit you want, you can select building 1, 101. You can search if this one, see, now I selected one. Okay, so this is all reports you can see here. And one more report is the in maintenance, real estate, all job card created. The same point that you can filter all job card with the status that, as you see here on the right side, all information of the status. Okay. And also this one, you can filter. Suppose you have maintenance for real estate, you fixed asset you can use. Because here this is fixed asset, look here on the top, we have here module for maintenance, module for maintenance. I believe I covered maybe all about maintenance in real estate module. Hope this video is helpful and thank you very much.
Your call is very important to us.